Crazy, then I'm gonna show you the shower tape brush, or how it's called. So the box looks like any other one. Boom, that's what you get in a box. In a box we get 2 INEMs, set of tips with the box, manual and a catalog. Manual is in English and Chinese. There you go. And that's how you change base settings on them. You get the extra filters that you can swap around. I'll show you in a minute. That was the reason I was interested in this headset in the first place. So let's continue. Then we get the product catalog. Which is what they are doing, selling. Tape bros, the singer, the soloist. The conductor. EJ707. Could have diluted like 007. Why not? H27. I always come interested when they, how they just call it like H27. Why did not call it like, I don't know, Cobalt Blues or something like that. No. Then we get Info Company 4 and so on. Continuing. Then we get a nice leather case. The box is very nicely fitted. Sticker on the back. Let's open it. One hand operation for the win. I've learned doing that by now. All around nicely. Boom. Ta-da. Besides, this way, that way, never mind. So you get even more tips. Then more tips. Nice looking. I'm not gonna be not used and of silicone tips. I'm gonna say why in a second. Brush for cleaning the INEM. Always useful, why not? A cable tying thingy. And 2.5 balance to 3.5 adapter. That in my case is a bit worn, so it's not any good to use for wire running or anything. And as I said, the tool that allows you to change the filters. And then let's get to the cable. That was in a box obviously as well. It is using the 2-pin connection. Very nice in touch, that's over the ear protection. Nicely wrapped around. Very nice weave. Double color. Nice and soft. Corvid. Continuing. That's how it looks. Very nice steel tape pro with a date of manufacturing, which was November last year. The tips I'm using, my silicone are my foam ones, and the filters, as I mentioned, that you can swap around to get some base extra bass out of him, which I'm gonna do in this very second. If it goes for sound, I do like him. This is gonna be divisive. It is a very specific EDM with specific sound to it. It uses one dynamic driver and one electrostatic, which is electromagnetic driver with a full range. I like basically the sound of it. Bass is very nice on the setting it's at. Very accurate. And most thing, important thing about them, when I got them, I've put those tips in. The standard ones with the headphones with me. It sounded absolutely horrible. Worst sounding in EM I've tried in years. It sounded like a teen, like a teenish sound. Shouty mids and top was absolutely horrible. But I fixed it up with the tips, sorted it out, and I've changed the filters inside. As you can see, I don't know. See, you can change those and they change the volume or modulate the sound or whatever, how they sound. And that fixed it, changing the those inserts and tips made it sound very good. Can I recommend it? Only if someone likes to play around with the filters and such. Because you can get BA Pro, which you don't need to mess around, and they're gonna sound basically as good as those. And they are cheaper as well, and they come with better cable and everything. So I would go with the Venture Electronics BA Pro if I was to choose between this ones and the other ones. For the reason that the other ones are just basically plug and play, sound good. These need tinkering around. And for the money they are being asked to pay for them, which is, I think, £120 on Amazon at the minute. Basically, they are not worth it. You can have better options, in my opinion, if you're not ready to mess around them. If you're going to be messing around them, I definitely can recommend those to anybody. Yeah, very nice. Oh, and a fit. I've spent with them 7 hours. Epic fit for my ears. 7 hours, and I had not had to use it in any way. It was just like part of me. Couldn't feel them. That's why I like them very much.